I'm Suzanne Rogers, and I'm honored to wrap up Women's History Month with an interview of a very talented coworker and dear friend and the longest-running cast member on Days of Our Lives, Susan Hayes. Susan Seaforth Hayes used to be known as Susan Seaforth, and then she got lucky. She married her leading man, Bill Hayes.
Well, all right then. I want to know about you before you went on Days. How did you become an actress?
I started working when I was 4 years old. First in the production of Madame Butterfly, playing the little character of Trouble with the New York Metropolitan Opera Company. My mother was an actress. That was a bonus in that, yes. I was told somewhat how to do it and did not take acting lessons until I was 15 years old. I had poisoned Lassie. I had played Queen Elizabeth on this very soundstage.
Oh my goodness.
On Hallmark Hall of Fame. Went on to do several shows in this studio for matinee theater. Those were the days in the 1950s when a lot of nighttime television was not in color. And in order to sell color sets, when the stores were open, they put 1 hour of color television in the middle of the day.
The following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
So how come you auditioned for Days?
In 1965, I auditioned for Days and did not get the job. I did a very good reading, apparently. Mm-hmm. Ted Corday didn't like the tape.
Yeah.
He looked at it and said, her eyelashes are too long. So
which
I lost.
They are.
So I lost Julie to another actress, and then she got fired, and then the next actress got fired, and then the third actress got fired, and they were casting again. In 1968, they loved the character. They were looking for the right person. That time, I scored.
Hello?
Hello, Grandma. It's Julie.
Oh, darling. I've been wondering when we'd hear from you.
15 years later, I'm having lunch with Bill Bell and have to ask, what did you see in me? What?
Yeah.
Why did you
ask? Why did you get?
Was it the scene? Yes. Was it the acting?
Yeah. I remember.
He said you had a very nice smile.
How nice.
So what was your first day like?
First day, I got to work with Frances Reed.
Ah.
It was a two-way telephone conversation with a split screen.
Darling? Grandma, how are you?
I'm fine, dear. How are you?
Oh, all right, I guess.
That first year was filled with anxiety and delight. Second year, you know, I'm still hanging out in the hall asking the producer, was it all right?
Yeah, we all
were. Was the scene okay?
Did you know we named the baby Hope?
No, I didn't. It's a lovely name.
The cast was small, extremely close. Remember the Christmas parties that Frances Reed,
absolutely,
who played Alice Horton,
absolutely,
would give?
And there were only 12 cast members.
Yes, and we all got along, and once I met Bill Hayes, I really was interested in working hard and getting along with particularly one member of the cast.
The most beautiful girl in the world.
That was our first kiss.
And he was so darling,
well,
cute and everything else.
Still is.
Okay, so what storyline challenged you?
The difficult ones have come more recently as our characters have matured a lot. Our health is always in jeopardy. When I was dying of my bad heart attack on the show, it was very difficult for Bill and I to play those scenes.
Oh, I have loved you.
Always.
And at one point, they had Billy, my husband Bill Hayes, murdered. And because he was a singer, he was stabbed in the throat. Sure. They had him laid out in the Horton living room in a coffin. It was absolutely terrible for me. Another scene I remember vividly. I played with Suzanne Rogers. I'm at Suzanne's country home.
Well, would you like to learn how to milk a cow or shear a sheep?
And we're cooking. And I opened the oven door, and the fire from the grease in the oven flies out over me. I have a double. Suzanne doesn't have a double. Suzanne has the responsibility of rushing in, picking up the rug that's on the floor, and rolling this other girl into the rug. If the girl is in that situation for more than 30 seconds, the fire penetrates through the fire retardant and can kill her, can cook her like a custard. Mm. Everybody was screaming their head off. I was so grateful, as was the company, that Suzanne didn't screw up that particular take.
All right, one more thing.
Oh,
one last question. What women had the biggest influence.
I was raised in a matriarchy. There was my grandmother, mm-hmm. my mother, and mm-hmm. me against mm-hmm. the world. Mm-hmm. My mother was charming and nice to be around and fun, but my grandmother was raising me. Came onto the show, there I am the granddaughter of Frances Reed.
Yes.
So that was easy to understand. Okay, Frances, I understand that you're the boss. Frances took being the boss pretty seriously with a lot of us.
A lot of us.
She was an example of how to do it right the first time mm-hmm. through.
Oh, Grandma, they are a wonderful family. And they can give him that sense of loving family that I have not been able to.
We vividly remember Frances saying, "You're not going to read the line that way, are you?"
Don't feel bad. You did your best.
But she was great, kind, open, mm-hmm. good, supportive mm-hmm. to everyone mm-hmm. on the set. I have a couple of ladies that I've been fortunate enough to work with. One of them is Patricia Craig, who is a soap opera fan and an opera star. From watching her on stage, I know that what is physically impossible to do mm-hmm. can happen. It isn't just actors on Days of Our Lives. It's the people that show up, do the work, love
right,
it,
right.
and leave the audience loving it too. Thank you, fans that have
Thank
stuck
you,
with
fans,
us.
Thank you, fans, please.
We've yes, loved talking
please.
With you.
Love you.
Thank you, Suzanne.
Bye. Okay, I want to eat.